Well, frustrated and forgotten, that's how a group of Melbourne mums are feeling when it comes to their children's education. So they're banding together with a petition to get their kids back on school grounds for term four. Elizabeth Tridon is just one of the mums behind this movement, and she joins us now. Elizabeth, good morning to you.
Hi, Carl.
I'd imagine everyone is feeling your frustration right across Victoria. How hard has it been?
Oh, look, it's been really hard, Carl. I think it's very hard for parents and students. But this really is about the children, and I think our children are certainly, you know, not enjoying this experience, but there'll be so many more children that are doing this really, really tough. There'll be children that are lost from education this year, and I think it's really disappointing that we've just forgotten about them. No one's been talking about it, Carl.
Yep, you're not alone. Sorry, you're not alone. We had a school principal on just a couple of days ago saying the same thing in terms of state school and a certain group of kids. I mean, the petition has already over 5,000 signatures that you've got. You're clearly not alone here, but will the Premier listen?
Well, I hope so. And I think really, you know, the rights of the child are sacrosanct in our society. They're not meant to be trod over like this, not meant to be taken lightly. It's gone on for a really long time. And I want the Premier to listen because I think our children are really, really suffering and we've got to take that seriously. And we've also got to think about the impact that this has had on them. I mean, everywhere else in the world, the debate on this has been ferocious. The expert medical advice is that the children are better off in school. It's about weighing up the risk and how do we get them back in school.
The Herald Sun has a report this morning on what looks like part of the blueprint for Victoria coming out of all of this. And it seems to indicate that they want the kids back at school. What if they don't?
Look, I think if they don't, I think there'll be a lot of parents getting very, very frustrated and a lot more vocal. And that's why we started this petition, to give people a voice, to give parents a voice. And, I got out of my tracksuit today, Carl, and I did my hair so that we could get that happening. It's been a while. And so we could get that happening and give a voice. And if you look at the petition and the comments on the petition, they're all fantastic comments, really great. And teachers are on there as well, which is really important as well.
I completely agree with you, and it's a wonderful thing for you to be part of and to get up and to do to try and motivate people to think about and to try and get some action. So good on you. Thank you for coming on our show. We really appreciate it.